Hey guys, Lord here, back with a new Monster Hunter Rise video. Today, I'm going to cover the most efficient way to farm Rampages quickly and get Defender tickets, as well as loads of monster materials to help you meld more charms in less time. Let's jump right into the video. So, in my last video talking about this, I said that you can hop into pretty much any Rampage you want and get good tickets. And while this is true, I have since come up with a much more efficient method. What you're going to do is first, you're going to look for 6 or 7 star Rampages that have a normal non-Apex monster. For example, this 7 star Regang or this 7 star Tigrex. There's also a 7 star Diablos and a 6 star Nargacuga, to name a few. You want these because, number one, they have less health and don't hit as hard as the Apexes, so you won't spend as much time maybe carding or the randoms carding or your friends carding or something like that. And number two, they only have 2 hordes, which means that you will be done faster than an Apex or another monster, no spoilers, which have 3 hordes each. Regardless of how good you are at clearing these, only having to do 2/3 of the hordes will always make these ones go by that much quicker. The reason I say to choose a 6 or 7 star Rampage and not a 5 star is that in the higher meldings, while you can use Defender tickets 5 and above, by just doing a 5 star Rampage, most of the tickets you get will be below 5 star Defender tickets. So, doing a 6 or 7 star, you're going to guarantee at least one level of tickets below that are usable for high tier melding. So with 7 star quests, you also get 6 and 5, and with 6, you also get 5. So you're essentially giving yourself more chances to get more melding materials. Now let's jump into what to do during the Rampage to ensure maximum tickets. So for starters, you're going to want to complete the objectives on the left side of your screen. Here's a bonus tip right out of the gate. If you get the objective, set up hunting installments like I have here, you can just spam one over and over and over until you've got it. I highly recommend that you do that as it allows you to unlock the cannon before the first horde even starts. The cannon is extremely good, especially since you can charge the thunder shots to deal a splash wave of 400 damage and inflict thunderblight. This is also big because it can count towards the Inflict Elemental Blight objective if you also have that one. If you do have the Stun Monsters objective, I suggest that you leave one or two people on a ballista so that way you can get the stuns and then use the other people on the cannons to drop the thunder ammo on them with the cannons. Be sure to be mindful of the other objectives as you want to complete as many as possible. The more you complete, the higher your final grade would be, and the more Defender tickets that you'll get, which means more charms that you can meld. You ideally want to aim for a grade of S or S+. The next thing you want to do to speed up your time is to utilize Wyvern Riding, as this allows you to deal damage to multiple targets. It is also some of the highest damage you can do when the counter signal is not active. So always keep an eye out for monsters that are ready to ride, then hop on them and wreak havoc across the battlefield. My final tip is that once the final boss does appear, in this case, Tigrex, you want to focus them. Try to kill them, because as soon as the boss dies, all the other monsters will bugger off, and the Rampage will be over. Be sure to carve and pick up any dropped materials from that monster, as you can also use these to help top off your melding gauge. So as you guys can see here, the randoms and I got S+, so we got a bunch of tickets, not to mention all the juicy extra monster materials that we get from the rewards. So let's go do some melding. So I was able to do 3 meldings, all with the parts and tickets to spare. I easily could have done more, but I felt like these 3 showcased exactly the point that I'm trying to make. This is a really efficient and effective way of farming materials that will allow you to meld just a ton of charms. That way, you're most likely to get the charm you're looking for. So guys, if the video did help you, don't forget to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe to the channel if you're not already. There's going to be tons more Rise content out on my channel, including guides, builds, etc., so be sure to stay tuned for that. I wish you all good melding luck, and happy hunting!